I welcome everybody to this leadership lecture today. Let me start with an apology from the country representative of Adenawa, that's Mrs. Idegard Berend Kigosi. For the past 4 years, we have been missing at this lecture. It was not our wish. But the past 3 years have caught us on the ways from Lagos or Port Harcourt to Abuja. So every day this lecture was held in the past 3 years, we were on the way back to Abuja. So that was why we were missing the lecture.
And as a matter of fact,
I just came back from Abuja yesterday night, and she mandated that I had to come here unfailingly because it has been too long we have not been participating at this event.
So,
she sends her greetings to everybody, and especially to the graduating students and the incoming students. She wished to be here, but because of another engagement, she cannot make it. By tomorrow, she'll be in Enugu for a 5-day training. So she had to prepare her papers and every other thing. That was why she had to excuse herself. So I would like to introduce the foundation called Konrad Adenauer. For the benefit of many people who have never heard about us, probably you have heard about the name on radio. We have been running a radio program on Red Power for the past 12 years. Every Wednesday, 1 to 2 p.m. called Vision Nigeria Radio Program. So if you have been chance to listen to it, please keep on listening to it every Wednesday, 1 to 2 p.m. And let me start with the name Konrad Adenauer. That Adenauer there may sound like a Nigerian name, especially Yoruba name, but it is not. It's actually a German name. Konrad Adenauer was the chancellor that replaced Hitler in Germany after the Second World War. He was the one that led Germany back to glory. He set the foundation for what we are experiencing now in Germany when he succeeded Hitler. He was from a political party called Christian Democratic Union, CDU. And the party, let me give an example how this runs. It's like having PDP or APC in Nigeria. And let's take the example of PDP. After, in 1999, Obasanjo was the first president under PDP. Then after leaving office, they now named a foundation from the political party, they named it after Obasanjo. That's how it is. No member of Konrad Adenauer works with Konrad Adenauer as we are talking now. No member of his family works with the foundation. But we bear the name Konrad Adenauer. So we represent a political party, but the political party does not dictate to us what we do. Although on our board, the Chancellor of Germany now, Angela Merkel, is chairman of the board of Konrad Adenauer in Germany. But they don't dictate to us what we do. The people who dictate to us, they are from the Ministry of International Cooperation in Germany. Those are the people who fund the foundation, not the political party. So the political party cannot dictate to us what we do. We should not be doing things to please the politician, but to please the German people in general. We call Konrad Adenauer one of the leading, or let me say, premier political foundation in Germany. Other countries all over the world have been trying to copy the Germans, but they have never been successful. The political foundation is something that is very difficult to run. It's very difficult. We have right now about 5 major political foundations in Germany, and as I said, CAS is the leading one. The responsibility of this foundation is to bring civic education to the people. They assume that if there was enough civic education for Germans, probably most of them would not have followed it like the way they followed it during the Second World War. So they now mandated all the political foundations to make sure that they educate an average German to know. Then after they recorded successes in Germany, they went to other European countries. They went from European countries to all over the world. So right now we have over 120 offices all over the world. And we cover about 160 countries. What do I mean by this? We have some offices that are regional. When you have regional offices, you cover some 2, 3, 4 countries. But we have national offices like we have in Nigeria, specifically for Nigeria. in Ivory Coast, we have a regional office for security issues that covers the whole of West Africa. So when you can, we have over 160 countries we cover all over the world. And right now, we have an office with the United Nations. We have a special office with the European Union. And we have an office in China, in Russia. Name the country, we have an office there. So, but the country office in Nigeria believes in this leadership idea. I remember when I was sent in 2010 to come and witness what was on the first school, that was the first set. I came there on a Saturday, and after witnessing what was done, I wrote my report and gave it to the country representative then. And I recommended that if there is anything we can do to help the foundation to say we believe in the new people who are coming in and we believe in the future of the country, I think we should partner with our center, LSD. And the country representative then agreed. And since then, we have been sponsoring and partnering to have this annual leadership lectures. And I can authoritatively tell you that if God wishes, we are still going to continue to fund this in the future. So, I wouldn't want to take much of your time. We do a lot of things in Nigeria, quite a lot, but if I want to start now, in the next 30 minutes, I will not stop. So, please, permit me to stop here, and I bring you greetings from the country. Thank you very much.